Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Best in Slot, and welcome back to what is finally going to be the final episode of our Eco Zoo park build. I've been sitting here for a couple of days now, like in-game days, not real-life days, that would be nutso, just trying to farm up enough points over here, our conservation credits, in order to buy the final two animals we needed, both of which were, of course, excessively expensive. But I managed to do just that. If we go into our animal store... If we go into our animal storage, you'll see we have a couple of hippopotamuses. We have Abio and Okechuku. And we also have Kyra, the Indian elephant. So we are going to pause the game. We're going to chill. We're going to build a really nice enclosure for one of them. And then we may not build a really nice enclosure for the other. We'll see what happens. All we need to do is power everything with renewable energy. Easy peasy. Cavalier's 900 guests, easy peasy, we have many more than that, and indeed the big challenge really has been the 13 habitat species. So we're going to start off with the Indian elephant because the hippopotamus scares me slightly because I have no idea where the hell it's going to live. Tell you what we should do. We should research a transport ride while all this is going on, I think. I'm going to leave the game on pause because I'm a madman. So we're going to build a... Where are we going to put this elephant? Is it going to go over here? Yeah, I think it's going to go in this gap right here, and then we'll try to curve this round maybe down to here for the hippo. It's kind of a pain in the butt, but we can't do much about that butt. So, that's actually a staff path. Interesting. I mean, we can change it. It's not a big deal. So all we're going to do is replace that with this, and we're going to try to make it look a little bit neater in the process. We're going to keep that little staff bit down there, because that's going to... connect onto the wind turbine, as you can see, and also the actual exhibit. What the blimmin' or have I just done? I'm just excited to finish this level. There's nothing wrong with the level, in a way. I just think 13 species is a little bit... Why do I keep doing that? I think 13 species is a little bit excessive, you know? And that has shown itself to be true, given the immense amount of time this level has taken. Taban is preventing other animals from breeding. Taban, you got... Why? Don't do that, Taban, you meanie. What are you up to? Wait, why would you... There's only two of you who can breed. What are you on about? I think I've only got a little babby. It's a new babby. Gansuk. Gansuk is adorable, but I don't think he's trying to sleep with his mother, so I don't really know what Taban's on about. Anywho's up. We're not going to go too complex today. One nice chill day. We're just going to get a nice big enclosure though for our Indian elephant. And we're going to make it fairly similar to this one, I think, design-wise. So let's grab ourselves some glass. Oh, no. No, stop it. No, God. Get out. No inbreeding allowed. Bad wolf. Bad. Anywho, so let's just focus. This is why I paused the game, by the way. We're very close to glory, and I don't want anything to mess it up. Inbreeding wolves, for example, would be one such thing. Let's get this straight across there. Wait, can we use glass for elephants? Ah, I didn't think about that, actually. Let's have a little look. What are the requirements to contain an Indian elephant? What level of protection do we need? 4. There's no way the glass is 4, is it? I don't think so. It's 2. Right, we're going to have to mix things up a little bit here. What can I do that would also blend in with the rest of the park is the main question. I don't know. What about electric? Oh, electric feels mean, you know? Maybe we're just going to do this in brick? Concrete? Concrete probably makes more sense. I don't know how I feel about it, but... We're going to cover it in windows is what we're going to do. And we can change around the colours a little bit. We can make it say... I can make concrete sexy, just believe me. Okay, I quite like this little ditch area, so we're going to integrate that. Maybe that can be sort of like a sleeping area, this little back bit. It's a big box, I think, if we're honest, but we're going to make it a nice box. I want them to be happy. Do you reckon that's big enough? Eh, we'll find out. So let's stick on a staff path. And open up our barrier over here. Get rid of that. Look, I've already got the... Come here. I've already got the straight line. Don't ruin my straight line, please. That's the way to do it. Lovely stuff. Right, let's get the elephants singular. I'd like another one. I'd like her to have a partner. But elephants are also crazy expensive. So what am I going to do? Ooh, Nile monitors. There we go. They're all going to start to grow up very soon. I'm going to start clearing them out. We're getting a little bit of credits for that. It's not exactly an abundance. Meh here. We need probably 500 or so to get an elephant, so it seems unlikely that's going to happen. But we'll see. You never know, folks. You never know. I'm wondering how we can... wondering how we can make this... We have a lot of Nile monitors, okay? They get busy. Let's put it that way. I could actually do with... What's going on? Oh, okay. That's okay. Nothing to panic about. I just want to get the elephant in, and then we can kind of plan things out a little bit better. Let's get some windows in here. I want this front wall to be windowed. Boop. Maybe tall. Like super crazy, crazy tall. And then bam, and then this would also raise, because I don't know why it wouldn't. And then this would also raise, because that looks silly. It's like a castle, it's like a fort in the desert. Might just change this to remove the window, this one right here. Should be one way glass, shouldn't it, really? Should be the other way, but one-way glass is a good idea. There we go. Not sure what's going on there, but that's okay. It's okay. It looks pretty cool from that side. Where's my bloody elephant? What's going on? There we go. Come on, Jimmy. Now, let's have a little look. Are you going to be happy, A, on your own, and B, with the size of the enclosure? Oh, she needs water. Oh, I can't really do much about that, Kyra. I'm sorry, love. There is no water on this bloody map at all. And the hippos, she'll be fine. She'll be fine. It's only a little bit of water she needs. It's not like a big requirement. She's going to be okay, I think. Let's go with yes. Yes, okay. what I might do, because I don't really have any ideas. I want to bring these up. They're about half the size. Bring that back down, because that's nonsense. And then bring this one down as well. Just so it's like all the walls are slightly different in terms of height. More 40. Castle-y. I don't bloody know what we're doing. Come on, you. Oh, right. It's hard for the game to always know what you want, in fairness. It's not going to look great. But we'll do what we can. We'll do what we can. Okay, so... how do we make a happy elephant? Let's focus on the plant coverage first. None of this prickly pear garbage. We're looking for Asia, and we're looking... I think we're going to stay away from tropical, just because there is a lack of water. So I think we're going to go for Asian grassland, which actually is pretty cool, because I feel like Asia and grassland is a combination that I haven't really dabbled in that much. And we can put baobabs in. So, you know, good times. Now, we do have to be careful. She's actually got a fairly limited amount. But there is nothing here, is there? Okay, I regret Asian grassland. We're going for temperate as well. Let's stick that in. Maybe that'll make me better. It's an improvement. Oh, but she's cute. Maybe she wants the cherry blossom enclosure. Is that mad? No, let's do it. Screw it. I'm going to give her like a little path through the blossoms. We're gonna put some grass in. We'll try to make it a little greener. It's never really gonna work, but we're at the end. We're at the end game. I just want to finish it and make it look pretty. Okay. Even if this is not the right environment at all for her, I mean it is. Like she'll be happy with it, and that's what matters. I'm thinking like a little bamboo thing down here, maybe like a little bamboo forest. I always find the Bengal bamboo is a little bit awkward. Just looks odd. I think just because of the height more than anything else, you know? Just kind of sticks out like a sore thumb, doesn't it? Or I put like a tree nearby. I don't know, it's weird. Yeah, I don't like it. I can't get over it. I've tried many a time, but it's not for me. Little foresty area down there. Maybe stick one little ash tree somewhere else as well. I don't like to have all my trees all concentric in one like little area. I think it's good to mix things up. This is going to look bizarre. The one thing I'm worried about is the grass is not going to look like grass. It's going to have that kind of... I know what I mean. I know what I mean. It's going to have that... Ooh, is this going to be a good idea? No, it's going to be a terrible idea. It could have been a good idea. Can any of this be a good idea? I kind of want to put something on here. It's like part of the wall. Just because the wall's really boring. You know, we need to spice it up a little bit. With a tree. Does that look stupid? I think so. Yeah, I feel like it looks dumb, but I feel like I'm going to do it anyway, you know? I don't hate it. I don't hate it. Which one is this? 4. Alright, I want to put one on this side as well. It's the final enclosures. You know, let's just go a little bit bloody nutso with it. How's that for a plan? It kind of frames the whole thing. Makes it pop out from a distance as well. How is she feeling about that? Where are you, love? There you are. Nope, that's a log. Okay, there you are. They are actually super cute, the Indian elephants. I do prefer them over the African. No offense to any African elephants watching, of course. I love you as well. It's just I just happen to prefer the Indian. I'm sorry. I really wish they'd given us some water. There is nothing I can do about it. I'm not going to redo this now, but I hope she'll forgive me. I don't really know what to do here. What we should do, the grass first. And I think I want to make it... Right, so let's go hard on the grass. How hard can we go? Ugh. Okay, right, let's just do that first. I want that as my base rather than anything else, right? So we can work from the long grass. Now, we do need a little bit of soil, which is cool. Because what I want to do then is bring that in, like I said, kind of like a path through... woodland. We're going to make this more woodlandy, but something like that. So that wraps around to there. There should be nearly enough soil, and then that can maybe drop down there. Just like a little... It's called a desire path. We talked about it in a past video. It just basically means a path formed through nature because that's the route that people take, or the route that animals... I think it's... Well, it's a game trail when it's animals, usually, but if it's humans, it's called the desire path because it's the path that people want to take. It's the path that people desire. And you see it in, like, universities and stuff like that a lot, where people cross over the field and eventually the grass sort of gets matted down and darkened and stuff like that. There we go. That looks better. This isn't... I'm worried. The oak trees I like, but they've kind of taken away all my opportunity to put foliage in the actual enclosure. Maybe we just put the oak tree inside. I just really want this to feel like a wood. Let's just walk him through. How do you feel about it? Okay, apparently those oak trees didn't count. Which is actually super helpful to me, so now we can keep those as decoration and we can have more... All part of the master plan, you see. I just want more of these, I think. Or maybe some of the maple. It's sometimes not aligning to surface is a massive pain. Why are you all sinking into the ground like massive nerds? I've got a aligned surface on. Why is it not working? Eh, there we go. That'll fix it. Pretty sure that'll fix it. No, what is going on? Tis confusion! I'm actually confused. This is bizarre. Whatever. Okay. It's just something. Fine. I want one over here, though. Isn't really working out how I would have liked. But, it's going to be okay. We can put rocks in and stuff as well to bring it to life a little bit. Can we use wisteria? That's not part of this, is it? That would have been cool, though. Oh, no, we can. Sweet. Okay. We got some clusters on the go. Like, on these... I just want to make the concrete less horrendous. So I'm going to stick stuff everywhere. Basically. If in doubt, stick on some stuff, you know? I just wanted to have like a little, what is it? What have I done here? What's wrong with me? What's my fundamental malfunction? I just wanted to have like a whimsical fun time. You know? It's kind of like when I think back to our first zoo we did back on the beta and our final enclosure was the giant fairground for some reason. It was absolutely nuts and way over the top, but at the end of the day, it didn't really matter at that point, so just kind of went for it. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. it's fine. Yeah, life is good. Okay, whatever. We need some Resmi King Proteas. Protea, there we go. There you go, that's how you align to surface, son. That's what I want to see. Very rarely, I usually hate align to surface, but this time that's what I want to see. You have to be a little careful here, because if it goes inside the enclosure... Actually, I'll tell you what, I'm going to do it like this. But if it goes inside the enclosure, it will upset her, and we want her to be nice and happy. I think it's going to cross over a little bit no matter what I do, though. This gap is a little bit tighter than I would have liked. And by a little bit, I mean substantially tighter than I would have liked. I usually try to leave a nice gap between the pathing and the wall, otherwise you kind of end up in this situation. It's just a little boring, you know? Inside, it doesn't have any Vavavoom. I like Vavavoom. Maybe we can find some other stuff to do. Let's get in her basic habitat stuff and we'll go from there. I is for Indian elephant. Ooh. I don't know why. I don't know what that was. I really don't. Okay, so let's get the food trough. I think we... Now, in theory, you shouldn't hide these away because then the guests don't get to see her. But then again, I don't really care about the guests. So, we're going to hide that down there. She needs a nice little private section, you know? Then again, she does also need... Go away. She does also need a shelter. Yeah, okay, I'm going to change my mind slightly on that. It's going to go there. It looks way too small for an elephant. But... Yeah, apparently not. I can go over there. Ah, that can go up there. It's fine. Whatever. Okay. I'm going to use the leaves, of course. And I really like the plant screen. The plant screen is pretty cool. I don't like the water one. It doesn't seem that she's happy with it, unfortunately. I think maybe having these... Is she going to walk through it? How big is she? Can she fit through that? Yeah, of course she can. We're just going to be stupid. So I'm going to put a few of these in. I'm going to have them, like, along the path. Live the dream, folks. Ah. That wasn't the dream. That was terrifying. Yeah, that might be a bit much. I'll do. It's all definitely a bit much, but that's cool. Right, she's going to need a feeder enrichment as well. Let's get a barrel feeder. Stick that down there. That should be pretty good for enrichment. Maybe a couple of sprinklers. I'll dot a few of these around. Gives it a bit of a, you know, you know what I mean? Whimsical feeling. Same thing. And I think that's that done. We need some rocks. Specifically, unfortunately, desert rocks. Which I was spelling completely incorrectly. It's not dessert. Although, that sounds pretty good. Dessert rocks, yeah. Gotta get my stack on, as per usual. As per usual, as the kids say. Probably, maybe. I don't need kids. Ah. The kiss noise. It's so confusing for me. You're a little baby rock. You're a little baby. No, you're a little baby rock. No, you're a little baby. You're a little baby. Yeah. Got there eventually. Oh, we're going to do this middle bit. Rocks. Rocks is what we're going to do. And we'll bring in some desert plant life, inevitably. Stop kissing. It's not the time. This is very serious. I need you to focus up, Planet Zoo. We're trying to make out. Bloody teenagers. Oh, that's quite nice. Get a little plant life in there. This looks ridiculous. But I don't mind. It's okay. It's okay. Sometimes you need it. I'm going to make like a little rocky middle layer. We've got this kind of like weird, awkward little middle layer here. So if we make it rock-based, then maybe that'll... We might do that. Also, that he's changing. Don't panic. I know you're all like, whoa, what's he doing? He's a madman. True, but not nothing to worry about. I actually don't know what I'm doing. Just gonna stick things in and hope for the best. I just wanted the rocks to kind of descend down and across this bit, because this bit is not somewhere I want her to be walking in a way. because we need to kind of fill this gap in a little bit, if we can. Without it looking silly, like that does. There we go. It's a shame it's desert rock. It would have been really nice to use something else, but... Beggars can't be choosers, all that. Actually, I could have definitely used something else that I completely had that choice, so I technically can be a chooser. Does that mean I'm not a beggar, or does that mean beggars can be choosers? I don't know. But that's basically what I wanted. I'd like to flatten this land out a little bit into the rock more, like so. And then that goes around there, and then we just smooth that out. And that's her pathway down to her bed and stuff like that. And the rock's just like an outcrop thing. Cool. Okay. Moderately happy. Moderately happy. Some decos. Actually, it's funny because technically we don't need to do this. Like, we're going to be done with this episode and we're never going to come back to the zoo. It's just the way it is. As soon as I get the hippo in, we are finished. Like, it'll pop and we'll be done. I don't know. Like, we've spent so much time on this zoo in general that it just feels a bit silly not to try, I guess. Oh, that's that. The hippos are going to be an issue. Just saying. You can't really read those, but that adds to the whimsy. Are we out of power over here? Yeah, okay. Wait, no. Ah, of course, when you duplicate it twice, it doesn't work for reasons. Science. Don't argue. I don't know, I've never figured it out, but that's how it functions. Yeah, okay, cool. Right, so. What I really want to try to do is get the mechanic research done on the transport rides. We do need to set up some stuff. Let's go grab our housing unit. There it is. Lovely job. Lovely job. Yep. I know, game. I know. Oh, down we go. Come on. Yeah, whatever. If it wants to fly, we'll make it fly. Move that over there. I'm going to change the path into a staff path. Okay. And we need to actually get a staff member. Ah. This is one problem. As soon as you go into fast mode, everything breaks and goes mental at once. It goes utterly insane instantly. Everything seems to be fine, though. Honestly, I think if you leave your staff members to it, generally speaking, they kind of get the job done. They really do. Right, yeah, so we need... Let me do my work! I need a staff member. This is why I pause things. I need a keeper. I need to pause it for a second. We're going to grab that keeper. We're going to go employment. We're going to add a new work zone. We're going to grab those. And... Olifant. There you go. What's your name, buddy? Amos Waldron. Sounds like a great guy. Can we train him from here? Oh, I can't do that anyway, yeah. Okay. So, we need some light. This is all very dark and spooky. Which is not really the feeling I want to invoke with my elephants. Look at them. It's about to be daytime, so I don't care anymore. Oh, look at her! She's a cutie! Is she happy? How happy are we? Yeah, I can't really do... Oh, right, we need, toy enrichment. What about skills? No. Mud bath? I'll give you a mud bath. Give anyone a mud bath, mate. There we go. The social is an issue, but I can't really do anything about that at this point in time. If we set this to Indian Elephant, I'll keep an eye out for a lad, you know? If we can find one, then we'll be good. But the pricing is going to be an issue. What is going on? Everything's going crazy. Okay, we're gonna pause things. It's gone too far now. We need to calm down. I need a little time to figure out what is going on. Oh, wait, and pause it. Ah. Oh, he's so cute. Oh, my God. Animals. Okay. What's our problem, right? You. Are you my baby? No, you're my baby. You are gone. Goodbye, baby. Scorpions. Scorpions. Oh, my God. So many scorpions. Okay. You're gone. You're gone. You're... Again, we just trade the babies out. Honestly, if you want to farm points, scorpions are actually one of the better ways to do it. Diseased animal, fantastic. What? Okay. What's going on? Why are you dying? What's wrong? Old age, that's okay then. Let's get the vet though, I don't really want a corpse lying around. Oh, the boa constrictors just have babies as well. All I want is the transport. That's all I wanted. I paused the game for 2 seconds and everything. Rah! Ah, who's diseased? Oh no! No! Oh, she's gone. She's safe. She's safe. It's fine. It's a little worrying that it can go to life-threatening when you've, she's already on her way to the vet and assumedly safe, but... Alright. Pause. Done. Just leave me alone, please. Jesus. I'll call the vet over. You know, that seems to be a thing they're complaining about. Whew. I just wanted a thing. I wasn't asking, I just wanted a train. Oh, right, okay. Again, this doesn't make much sense, but it's a final enclosure, so what are you going to do? Wait, did I already have a monorail? Wait, was that pointless? It was, wasn't it? It absolutely was. Okay, cool. That's what we like to see. So, let's put that there, I guess. I'm just going to attach this. Yeah, whatever. We're just going to head over to this side, because what we need is where the water kind of... But the land kind of drops down gradually into the water, otherwise we can't really build an exhibit there. As you saw when we attempted to, over here, and it was a little bit of a disaster. I'm going to go up a little bit. Yeah. Swing over there. Back down again, please, my love. Thank you. And they do need a decent amount of space, the hippos. That should be enough, right? The plan is to have the exhibit right here. I should be fine. Get a station in. Don't know what that means. But wait, entry left, exit left. That would be both on that side. That's what I want, I think. Yes, looking good. Right, let's curve back around. Not that curvy. I really wish this was... I don't know. Could they do this a different way so it was a little bit easier to control? You know, so it was kind of like... You know, like building the monorail on Evolution. And I suspect not just because... Oh, there we go. Just because it is much more complicated in a lot of ways, but... There we go. In theory, this should work, I think. It's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Might have to change the station. We'll see. Actually, I probably do have to change the station. Station 1, closed. Place entrance. Okay, 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 okay. Place exit. Okay, okay, okay. There we go. And this has to be connected to a queue. I know that much. Oh, excuse me. Bloody Nora, my mouth hurts. Okay, good stuff. Right, and just gotta do the same with the other side. Hopefully they're both on this left-hand bit. Problem. What's the problem? What's the problem? Not telling me what the problem is. Vite has one or more issues. Check that track is in a loop and stations are connected. Well, they are, right? And it is. Alright, am I going crazy? No. Is this too... Is this too close to the ground? I don't think so. Is it because it's unpowered? Yeah, that's why. Okay, not a problem. Just need to grab ourselves a lovely jubbly... Oh, I really hurt my mouth. The wind turbine. As long as it clips it, we're okay. Just stick that over there. No, not over there. That's all going to be habitat, so do it over here. And then we'll have like a little staff path that comes down here, and we'll do the staff room there as well. Cool. Okay, now can we do it? Let's find out. How are we feeling? Feeling good? Feeling sexy? Yeah. Okay, good stuff. No, you want the X... Actually, you... Well, the exit to be on this side. Okay, good stuff. Let's drop that down. And that's basically going to be a straight line, and that's it. That's all you get. You come here, you see the hippos, you go home. That's it. Okay, I've just realised what I've done wrong. We need to do this... I need to do these on the other side, because I want you to walk... Yeah, no, that makes more sense. So, entrance. Exit. Entrance. Yeah, that's the only way it makes sense. Okay, cool. Drop down, straight across. Let's go that way. That's fine. That's plenty of room for the hippos, I think. The hippos definitely need more water than anything else, so they should be relatively happy. Do that. And then we can drag the queue down, and that kind of attaches nicely onto this, whereas I think the other way would have looked a little bit funky. And as funky as I am, I'm not in the mood. There we go. Right, are we open? Yeah, we are open for business. I don't know if that was on purpose, but that's what it sounded like. Right, good stuff. I kind of want to do something in the middle, like a giant statue made out of bone or something. I don't know. Let's get this blimmin' enclosure done, shall we? Oh, do hippos break out? What? I think I can have glass hippos. No, grade 4. Wow, okay. Okay, we'll do concrete again, because we'll just keep it similar to the... elephants, I guess. We'll leave a little bit more of a gap this time. That should do. We can get rid of the... a little bit of a funky shape. And then we'll get into here and we'll go for the steel mesh. Maybe that's what I should have been doing. Steel mesh. Eh, what are you going to do? I don't know if that's going to be enough. Because the hippos are very greedy when it comes to the water. But we shall see. And that is beautifully even. I don't think that's going to be big enough, you know. I think we can do like a little staff section coming off there. That might look pretty cool. And yeah, okay, I like that. Where's our staff building thingamajiggy? There's our staff building thingamajiggy. Lovely stuff. We're going to put this over here. Might have to kill a couple of rocks, you know. Just a couple. Get that nice and straight. Can't hide it. It can chill by the water a little bit. I like that. You know, they get to... look out their window and see dirt and a little bit of water, which is what I wanted. Got to keep the staff happy as well at the end of the day. Or at least moderately okay. As long as they don't quit on me, I don't really care. Right, so that's our thing. Gonna put that there. Get rid of that. Get rid of that. Gonna get rid of all this, assumedly. Let's just do it now, actually. Obviously, the hippo is African. Technically, you could argue South American at a push, given the wild hippos in South America. But really African, and despite those being African, it is desert, which I don't think the hippo would be as fond of. I don't know, I'm not a hippo. Or am I? No, I'm not a hippo, so I don't know for sure. I'm taking an educated guess. I could be a hippo. What am I even saying? Alright, okay, so let's connect these all together, hopefully. Yes, lovely. Knife hiccups. And then that's going to connect straight onto there, like so. Clear a couple of these cacti off. And these, if that's a cacti, that's a yucca. So that's a yucci, I guess, yeah. And that's another cacti, unfortunately, so I can't keep making that same joke. What's this? It's in the way. White sage. Bushai, or baish, or boy, I'm gonna call it a boy. Okay, so with all that done, let's get our hippos gathered up, send them in there. I think the enclosure is too small the more I look at it, but we'll have to wait and see. And we need to get a staff keeper kind of man or woman. It's a lad this time. His name is George. Maybe it's Gary. I'm gonna change it to that was terrifying. I'm gonna change it to George. Because he will do what I say. Employment, work zone, bloop. Hipsos. There we go. And now he works for the hippos. You're going to be okay, Kyra. Don't you worry, girl. Aww. I've never really gone in here to look at this. Oh, that's so sad. I don't want to look at that. I don't want to see that. I kind of can't root there. February summary there, nah. Power source in Excel. Oh yeah, of course. Herp derp. Move all this nonsense. Okay. Does it? I want to see someone use the monorail. No one's here. Why is no one here? Just because they have to walk across half the blooming zoo to get here is no excuse. There were people here before to see the elephant, and now they've all disappeared as well. They're all just looking at the flamingos, which is silly. Not that I've got anything wrong with flamingos, but still. Flamingos aren't the animal you go to the zoo to see, you know? They're an animal that they kind of like have lying around in the zoo for some reason. Some very angry flamingos watching this video. yeah, there we go. I want to bring this up again like we did with the elephants, I think. I kind of want to make it mesh. Maybe I'll do concrete at the side, just to make it feel a little bit different than the elephant. What we're going to do is we're going to grab that and that and that, and we're going to make this mesh instead and bring it right back down. I think the hippos probably have a minimum size and that's probably not going to fulfill it, so we'll have to sort that out as well, but we're getting there, folks. We're getting there. Sometimes I wish there was a better way to control this height individually. Hey, there we go. Meow. There are... Oh, wait, there's no one in it. It's empty. Oh, so disappointing. Oh, God. Where are my hippos? Seriously. Oh, they are on the way, apparently. Oh, they can't get here, can they? Right, that's my bad. Okay, what are we going to do? I got a plan. I thought they just did come on the thing, but obviously they're not going to do that. The staff are not going to sit there with a box of hippo and transport it across. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to grab a... where is it? We're going to grab a trade center. Stick that there, and we're going to hire a caretaker. We're going to delete this anyway. Are we? Yeah. We might keep the caretaker here, though. I just realised that the staff are completely excluded from the rest of the park, so obviously nothing's going to happen. And now we should be able to get the hippos delivered. He should go straight in there and do it. There we go. Right. I'm just going to wait till the second one's in. Because you can't tell if they're happy until they're both there. Because it does determine the amount of space they need. Hippo win. And there we go, we can pause it. Right, how are we doing? Ah, it's too small. It's way too small. Way too small. Yep, okay, oh my god, the ground. Oh, okay, we have a problem. No, we can fix this. This is not gonna be difficult. I'm just gonna flatten all this. Not a problem, folks. No, it's fine. I knew it was too small. I remember the hippos, like, are, what was our zoo called again? The one we made in the beta? I actually can't remember what the zoo was called. Oh, Buravichar had hippos. And they required an immense amount of space. So. There we go. Right, hopefully that counts. God, it's not as long as it looks, is it? Right, we need a little... I'm going to place a lot of that with concrete as well. Concrete. Okay, and we're back into the water, then we go back into the mesh. Yeah, why not? And then we're going to come out from there instead. Get that nice and straight. Basically going to... I don't know why I'm using the straight lines, but we are. Just going to give them basically the entirety of the rest of the lake. They're hippos. They need moist. Just to sum it up, they need moist. There they go. They have moist now. It's about three times as much. Honestly, that might be... I'm touch and go as to whether that's going to be big enough. I think it actually isn't land-wise. I think they probably need a little bit more still, but let's see what that does. It should be enough water. Oh, it's nowhere near enough land. Wait, oh, they can't get across, so that's why. Wait, why? What? There's nothing there! What are you on about? Of course you can get across here. Ah, come on, you silly hippo. Come on. Right, there we go, that's an improvement. It's close enough that we're okay with it. What's going on here? How can they get out of that? Jumpable escape point. I find that very hard to believe, guys. But okay, whatever you say, I'm not here to argue. Whatever you say. There we go. Nonsense. Absolute nonsense. Okay. I'm going to swap this into concrete as well. I don't want you to view from this side. Alright. Okay, cool. Cool, 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 cool. Do-do-do-do-do. So, when we look at this, that should be... What? Where's my 13? Game, don't do this to me. I was on 11, I already did an elephant, and I did a hippo. Oh, I've run out of a species, as one of them disappeared. It could be. That could be it. Let me have a little look here. Did something die of old age? Right, we need to have a little look in our zoo. Right, bloody Nora. Camels are fine, wolves are fine, these are the buffalo, they're fine. That's all we had over here, right? Yeah. Oh, do we not have Nile monsters anymore? Is that why? That's it, precisely. So, okay, panic is temporarily over. We just need a Nile monitor. That's all we need. Just need a Nile monitor. There we go. Lovely stuff. Let's grab a little pair. Why not? I was genuinely worried there. I was freaking out a little bit. Bloody Nora. Alright, what's all that's going on? We'll just play normal. No! Well, I'm going to try and make the hippos a little happier anyway. So, we need their habitat stuff on a basic level. Do, 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 do. Was I a rhinoceros instead of... Oh. I think I was on Indian rhino rather than Indian elephant. How many people yelled at me about that? Where is it? Oh, it definitely was. Oh, they don't have the... I knew it looked small. And I knew they'd have the bloody water thing. Grrrr. Okay, we're going back. We're going to fix that. That's an issue. Where's my beautiful elephant? She's over here. Okay. It did seem like it was a little bit of a tight fit. I was surprised that they were going to try to make her squeeze through that. That's more like it. It's freaking ginormous. That's what I expected. There we go. Much better. And it gives her the water that she wanted, you know? Anyways, hippo. Hey, and I'm gonna pause it again. Right, so. Let's get some of these in. I love these things. These things are just the best, and I want them all along this bit here. Now we tried this before. We actually tried this in ours. Oh, what? Oh, the game won't let me stack them together, which is sad. Okay. I just love them. They make me happy. Why does that look so weird to me? Am I going crazy? No, it's fine. It's the angle. Whew. Is that smaller? Yeah, let's go for a slightly smaller size there. I really like the leaves bedding. I just feel like it fits the animals a bit more. So I'm going to have this kind of... A little funky with it, you know? They come out a little bit. Bam, look at that. Bam. Spilling out all over the place. You know, the hippos. They like to get wet and wild. As the kids say. In the 50s. These should be more over here, though. Okay, that should be happy hippos, I think. So we just need to do their nature. So I think it's African grassland. Should we tell you what? Should we get to daytime so I can see what the hell I'm doing? I do love those. They're very cool. Guys, where are my hippos? There it is! Hello! Just chilling on the bottom, doing hippo things. Just standing there. Oh, wait, you have a problem. Oh, the bloody... Oh, this whole vet not being able to cross over here. This whole malarkey is an issue. Do I have humans here? Yay, there we go. We're going to get some more lights around here. We need to hire a vet. And we need to set up a veterinary station right here as well. Is it surgery or quarantine? It's surgery, right? I think so. And hire a... Nope. Hire a vet. Alright, let's get that go. She should get straight onto it. Yes, lovely stuff. Nope, yeah, no, she's thinking about it. Oh, she's got him. Cool. Okay, that's sorted. I'm just going to carry on until daytime now. Where's my hippo gone? All I see is poop. I don't see an actual hippo. You're not dead yet. You've been there for hours. Like, I know you're good at, like, living underwater, don't get me wrong, but I think you may be taking it a little bit too far. Continent. Africa. Biome. Aquatic and grassland. Cool. I am obviously going to have a baobab. Eh! Wait, escaped? What? How have you done that? What? How did you just... What have you done? She just swam through the fence. I don't think I can be blamed for that one. That seems a little bit harsh. Dangerous animal escaped because she became a ghost, essentially. Yeah, sure. I can't counteract ghosts, I'm afraid, as try as I might. That's actually a really nice looking little thing. I really like this like slim line of grass and then this big open lake for them to swim around in. You know what I mean? I'm on a rabbit. Don't judge me. Rabbit. Can we have any... I never really want to do too much in the way of plant life in this whole place just because of the ground colouring more than anything else, really. Stick some of those down. Elephant. Now it's not a reed. It's elephant grass, but I kind of like treating it like a reed. I think it tends to end up looking better. I love this stuff. It's like my favorite thing. Oh god, it's too far already. Never mind. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I take it back. What the hell? Wait, is that going to recalculate? No. Wow. Never mind. Not allowed any plant life. That's all they're getting. We're done right there. Okay. I think it's not perfect, but we are about to leave in 10 minutes and never see this again. So I think I'm relatively happy. I actually think the whole area looks quite nice. This whole thing could do with deco, blah, 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 blah. What is that there? That crocodile? Nope, that's... What is that? Huh. What on earth? Is it a cloud? I think it's meant to be a cloud. It's terrifying. It's like some demonic sea creature. The thing we have to do now is try to replace all our power sources with good power sources. Not you, you bad power source. Oh, everything died. Yeah, that would do it. Go. And we have to power everything, so it doesn't mean, because these don't have quite the range of the of the others. We do need to find spaces for them, essentially. Okay, what are you? You are a goodie, you're a goodie, you're a goodie, you're a baddie, you're a bad boy. Okay, all powered. You're not powered, which is a problem, but one we can pretty easily fix. And it's finally over! It took so long.
That our first suit would be this successful. Oh, and I could not have done it without you. Thanks to your efforts, we've made an incredible contribution to the Timberwolf Ecology Restoration Project. And, even better, the zoo is running completely on renewables. I mean, I know this is what I asked for, but I just didn't believe we'd make it this far, so fast. You know, other than the animals, you really were the only good thing about Mr. Meyer's zoos. Oh, and now that he doesn't have you working for him, he's really cutting costs to the bone. I hear he actually tried passing off a habitat full of house cats as pygmy lions. Ugh! I mean, the sooner we get rid of him, the better.
This would do something like that in... Was it in China? I think it was in China. They tried to pass off... Let me try and remember what it was. Was it a dog as a lion and they kind of shaved it up to the mane until it had like this big fluffy mane and it was clearly a dog, but they said it was a lion. It was something like that. That's a balloon. Hello. Boop. That's depressing. Okay, wow. It's finally over. It took bloody ages. This zoo alone, was literally the same length as like probably over half of the rest of the campaign. It's been nice to do a detailed, pretty zoo. I don't know if it's the best idea for every episode going forward. I will say that part of the problem isn't just that we tried to design it and make it look relatively nice. Okay, I got a little bored towards the end, but generally speaking, we tried to make the whole thing look nice and kind of come together, you know. And I think it's a nice looking zoo. I think you could do this in... You'd want it neater, but I think you could do it in franchise and you wouldn't be upset about it, generally speaking. Maybe I'm crazy, but I think it's okay. There's some nice little bits. I really like that bit, for example. And if we head down here, there's our buffalo. Yeah, I am happy with it. And then we've got our little sort of looping path down here to see the snow leopards and the brown bears. And you nip down here, you go to our crocodilian section with the saltwaters and the gharials. And obviously this would need lots of decoration and stuff. But generally speaking, I am pretty happy with how the whole thing's turned out. But it took bloody ages. It took so... Oh my god, yes. It took so... This is nuts, by the way. There's so many people there. I think there's maybe a better middle ground, but I will say, it wasn't necessarily the design that made this take so long, it was simply the game asking for 13 habitat species, and limiting us. There's only 14 habitat species on the level. The only one I didn't use was the orangutan, so it was expensive habitat species as well, and very generally ones that couldn't live together. I don't think we've got any animals that are actually living together. I think we actually have 13 habitats. So, the level made it very, very difficult to do anything efficiently. You had to make individual enclosures, which is a pain. I could have maybe put like the buffalo and the camels together, now that I think about it. I'm sure there was a couple of places you could have done it, but generally speaking, it wasn't going to work that well. Maybe flamingos with the elephants, or flamingos with the hippos. Anyway, it's over. So, next level, next video, whenever, whatever, we will be... moving on to whatever the next mission is. Now, I want to hang out with my animals for a little bit. The reward for all our work. We have our Mama Hippo. Is that Mama? I think that's Mama Hippo. She's lighter and pink. Abio. How you doing, girl? She's Norman. Doing her thing. Showering down. Oh, wait. What I'd like as well, if we can, is to get enough points to get a male... I wanted another elephant. And the big moister boy turns up to join in with the pie. Gonna grab my thumbnail if you don't mind. I'll do. Boop. Boop. And boop. Boop. Yeah. I do appreciate the design difference between these two. It's quite pronounced, actually, in the buzz. Well said, girl. They don't have whiskers, though, and it upsets me every time I see them. The pygmy hippo has whiskers. Why does the big hippo not have whiskers? Very confusing. He's a chunky boy. I love hippos. Look at him. How can you not adore them? Oh! There you go. What a way. Oh, God, the fire. It's non-stop. Oh, he's very pleased with himself as well. They're so cool. They really are. Okay, that might be the thumbnail instead. He's such a happy hippo. He's a chunky boy. Actually, that's not going to work. The angle, it should always be that side for this to work perfectly. We'll see. Are you two going to have beautiful babies, or...? Aww. They're cute together. She's still looking how happy she is. Oh, they're doing the babies. They're doing the babies. This is the thumbnail. This is the thumbnail. And it's a good opportunity to hang out with our animals as I do it. That's my excuse. I'd like a better shot of them together. Alright, I think she's pregnant now. In case your school education... he just walks off. In case your school education system failed you... Oh, floating bush. Nice. That's how sex works. So... Where is... There she is. I feel for her. She's on her own. She's filthy. She's filthy and she can't clean herself. Because there's no water. So she's just going to stay filthy forever. I want to get her a partner. I feel bad leaving her alone. I know we're never going to even click on the bloody level again, but it feels mean. Feed her. Wash her.
Nom nom.
Nom nom. Come get your nom noms. No, she's not interested. Kyra. Oh, can she clean off in the sprinklers? Yes, very cool. Okay, no, I'm happy again. Kyra, nom noms. I'll reset it for you. There you go. That works really well, yeah. Nom noms. Just gotta grab a few just in case. You never know which one you're gonna want to use, really. I don't know, maybe she's just like a cool, independent bachelorette kind of thing, doing her own thing. She don't need no man. Kyra's got her own thing going on. She don't need no man elephant wandering in there, making things stupid. Anywho, we're gonna end it there. Thank you for joining me. That is the end of the Eco Zoo. I will think about what we're gonna do for the next one in terms of the building effort. But it will depend on the mission itself as well. We'll just see what our tasks are and we'll go from there. I'm very excited to find out, though. I'm very excited to move on from this mission. Not that it's been bad, but it has been long. Anywho, thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Rainbow.